This is gonna blow y'all's mind. Sorry to hype it up right away, but
what we'll do is we're gonna switch into this software that's called OpenSpace. It's actually NASA funded, all open source. Anybody can download it. It's totally free.
Would you be willing to tell us a little bit about what OpenSpace project is?
Yeah, for sure. I'm actually wearing the t-shirt right here.
Hey, cool. So
OpenSpace is a data visualization software. We got a grant from NASA to take the data that they collect from around the solar system and the universe and to make a piece of software that enables showing that data in a really rapid way in scientific institutions like yours.
So as we look at craters, we see them kind of changing morphology by size. The smallest craters are simple pits. The larger craters end up having a central peak.
Oh, and Josh is bringing up a really cool messenger map. This is like some combined data. Is this like some of the mineralogy that we were able to get from spectroscopy?
And combined with some analysis of what the surface color would look like, exaggerated to a huge degree to give us that variation, but it's a way of representing a different view of Mercury than the one we're used to seeing of that flat gray.
So solar storms actually have multiple parts. You have the flare that arrives at the speed of light, and then you have the protons, the radiation, that can arrive within 30 minutes, and then you have this cloud of material that can take a few days to arrive at the Earth.
It really looks very dramatic. It's kind of scary to think the sun's sending these out.
Do maybe almost 5 days a second. So you see, this is about 5 days every second. So that's why Earth is spinning like that. And you can get a sense of how these are flying around. These are potentially hazardous asteroids. What does that mean? It means they have the potential to hit Earth.
So we're seeing a lot of these cracks and fissures. Europa's got a very erratic surface, and we think that's because it's actually an active world. There's movement happening beneath as you've got water upwelling, the surface cracking, and there's even some hope that when we send something like the Europa Clipper out in a few years, we'll be able to spot that activity on the surface and maybe pick out a spot for a future spacecraft to go inside the surface of Europa and swim around in those oceans.
Wow.
Mount Fuji is part of the Ring of Fire that surrounds the entire Pacific Ocean. And it's a wonderful, iconic feature. Of course, the Japanese revere it, and it's a very great tradition in Japan to climb Mount Fuji. And I think if we get close enough, we'll actually see the trail going up the mountain. And you can imagine the walk up that side of that volcano. The glory of this system is that we can go to places that are actually very difficult to get to, and we can look inside the crater of Mount Fuji, which is a pretty special experience here. We're right on the crater rim, and we're gazing into the maw of Mount Fuji.
One of the really great strengths of OpenSpace is that we can take the camera view from the spacecraft and combine it with a different data set, this 3D model, and visualize what the spacecraft was seeing. And because this is real data, we can fast forward or rewind through all of the different data that we have in OpenSpace. And this allows us to see how these different objects change through time.
So, you know, one of the cool things that maybe people think of stars kind of painted on the sky, right? But they're actually just all in different places in 3D space. And they might look like they're in the same place because this guy's a lot brighter and another one's a lot dimmer. And so then the farther brighter one looks like it's in the same place as the dimmer one. But as we can see, these are the lines that are connecting the stars that make those constellations. And some of those stars are way far out compared to the other stars.
Folks who are checking this out from home and you want to try out some of the same stuff, we are using the OpenSpace software from the OpenSpaceProject.com. And if you were to load it up on your computer and plug in this date, you can see down here is Wednesday 25th, 1968 at 6:55, let's call it 21, GMT, you could see the exact same view from your home computer. So if this is a cool looking thing to you, by all means, go check it out.